Hello friends, good morning and welcome you all to the second semester of agriculture. And today we are going to start the course of horticulture, HOT 2.2, and the title is Production Technology for Fruit and Plantation Crops. Okay, so this one is the syllabus for theory as well as practical, and these are the reference books that you have to refer during the course whenever needed. Now let us start with the importance of the fruit growing. Okay, so friends, the fruit growing is one of the important and paying branches of the horticulture because it pays a lot to the nation. It has been practiced in India since times, and the art and it is the art and the science has now developed into the one of the most devised, skillful and intensive forms of the land utilization. The standard of living of the people of country is judged by the production and per capita consumption of the fruits. And fruit growing has several economic advantages also. So fruit growing is really an very important for the nation. Now which are the advantages? So let us see one by one. It is, first one is the per capita or per unit yields are very high in the horticultural crops because it is well maintained and established orchards being better returns than many of the field crops. So other than field crops, we are having a lot of returns in this. It is a really a paying branch, and a lot of yields are there in this horticultural crops, including fruit crops. From a unit area of the land, more yield or the income is realized than any of the agronomical crops. Income realization means net income is better as compared to the other agronomical crops. And the average yields of papaya and banana are 10 to 15 times more than the agronomical crops. So per unit area yield, or you can say productivity per unit area, is very high as compared to the agronomical crops. So this is an advantage of this horticulture. Out of the total area under the cultivation, grain crops account 72% with the production of 210 million tons, while due to very high productivity in fruit crops, it yields over 60 million tons from only 0.7% of the total cultivable area. So as you know, as compared to the 72% area has been covered by the agronomical crops, or you can say grain crops, as compared to that, we are having only 0.7% of the total cultivable area. Even though 60 million tons production is there, productivity is there. And the another advantage is high net profit. Through the initial cost of the establishment of an orchard is very high, it is compensated by higher productivity or due to high value of the produce, because whatever the acreage is, this area is there, but whatever the produce we are having with us, it is of very high value. So per kg or per ton, this costing is very high in these horticultural crops. So high net return can be gained. In cashew nut, through the average per tree yield is less than, very less. That means 4 to 5 kilogram per plant. But due to its very high market value, that is 200 to 250 rupees or more than that per kg, it fetches higher economical returns, that is 800 to 1000 rupees per plant. So we are having this 1000 rupees per plant yield, I mean rupees, as compared to the other agricultural crops. You can see the comparison of wheat, groundnut, grapes, banana and sweet orange. Average yield has been given, harvest value is given rupees per hectare, and final production value per hectare is given. So you can see the realization of the this price is more as compared to the wheat and groundnut in this grapes, banana as well as in the sweet orange. Now the source, it is a source of the raw material for the agro-based industries. Fruit farming provides raw material for the various agro-based industries like canning and preservation of the fresh fruits. So it is a mother of all the industries, we can say. And efficient utilization of the resources we can have in these horticultural crops, like the soil, water, farm machinery, everything can be utilized more in these horticultural crops. agronomic crops have slack seasons, while we are not having any slack seasons at all in this horticulture crops, because one or the another crop may be available in the field. Fruit growing is perennial in nature, and in this agricultural crops we can say we are having this slack season, as we told. Utilization of the waste and barren land is possible under these horticultural crops, because certain crops are there when there is a poor land, or you can say shallow or undulated soils are there, then no crop is possible, agronomical crop is possible to grow there, or if it is very difficult to grow there in the agronomical crops. But in these horticultural crops, we can say cashew nut, mango, or a lot of horticultural crops are there that we can plant in these fallow lands, or you can say which is undiluted or unutilized lands. And ability of earning foreign exchange is possible more in the horticultural crops. Many of the fresh fruits and processed products and spices are exported to the several countries, earning good amount of foreign exchange. Out of the total exports of agricultural produce, rupees 2900 million, horticultural crops, which mostly includes fruits and its produce, contribute rupees 1546 million, that is 52% of the total export of the agricultural produce. So it is really very attractive figure. India earns a foreign exchange of rupees 277.4 crores by exporting spices. So finally, we can say as compared to the other crops, agricultural crops and other branches, this horticultural branch is the having the most ability for earning the foreign exchange. And it is one time capital investment. In agriculture, we have to invest every season, every 4 months, every 6 months, or annually. But in this horticultural crops, we have to invest once only, and we can have the harvest, or we can have the yield till 30, 40, or 50, or sometimes 100 years. And we are able to have the continuous flow of the money in horticultural crops, because in agricultural crops, we can have the yield once in a year or twice in a year. But in these horticultural crops, we can have the flow, or continuous flow, because one or the other fruit crops can be grown in this field. Fruit growing in kitchen gardens helps to reduce the family budget on the purchase of the fruits. This is also one of the main benefit. Planting of the trees helps to maintain the ecological balance and to increase the precipitation of the locality. Fruit trees for such planting programs also generate economy. Fruit trees farming also reduce soil erosion, silting, tanks and air pollution. It generates employments. Fruit trees farming being highly intensive and skillful entrepreneurs, and generate employment even for trained persons. So finally, we can say it is having a continuous flow of the money, and it is also a helping hand for the this society, or we can say for the economy, for the ecological situation, as well as for the laborers also. So this was all about that. And now, importance of fruit as a food. This was for the earnings and everything. Now this one is the importance of the fruit as a food. So fruit is important because the importance of the fruit in human diet is well recognized since long. Men cannot live on the cereals. Fruit and vegetables are the essential for balanced diet and good health. Nutritionists advocate 60 to 85 grams of the fruits and 360 grams of the vegetable per capita per day, in addition to the cereals, pulses, eggs, etc. So this one is a very important one. Fruits and vegetables are good source of the vitamins and minerals, without which human body cannot maintain proper health and develop resistance to the disease. So this is also an additional benefit and the importance for the fruit, because we can fight against the disease. They also contain pectins, cellulose, which stimulates the intestinal activities, and energy giving substances like oil, fats and proteins. So overall, we can say for the human body, these fruits are very much essential because of the pectin and cellulose also. Many fruits have medicinal purpose also, that we have seen in the last semester also. Each and every fruit crop is having a this medicinal properties, and in the further in the next semester also you can see this. It is a source of the vitamins. So now the recognition or the importance of the vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C has been seen. So vitamin A, which is found most in the mango, papaya and fruits of the dates and banana. Vitamin B for the beriberi, deficiency caused by beriberi disease because of the deficiency of this vitamin B. We can come out from this by consumption of the vitamin B, and we can have this maximum vitamin B in the cashew nut, almond, banana, apple, bell, lychee, papaya and pomegranate. And vitamin C, nowadays in this pandemic of this corona, that is COVID-19, vitamin C is gaining a lot of importance. And doctors are also prescribing vitamin C tablets. So rather than consuming their tablets, we can have a lot of source of vitamin C in these horticultural crops like onla, guava, citrus fruits, bear, strawberry, pineapple, etc. It is also a source of the minerals like calcium, ferrous and phosphorus. We can have it. Now calcium, iron and phosphorus, the importance is known to you, and you can go through this. And it is also as a source of the energy. It is also very important. Carbohydrate and fats provide energy, while proteins, besides providing energy, are also responsible for building body tissues. Most of the fruits are good source of the C, H and O, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. And sources are banana 36%, grapes 20%, custard apple 25%, apple, bear, cashew nut. So all are having more or less the source of this energy. And to meet or 0.5% acre of the image or 0.9% acres of the banana. Fruits have medicinal values also. Fruits like onla, pomegranate, kokum, jamun, bihara have great medicinal values. It has been recognized in the Ayurveda for last long. So it was all the importance for the as a food and as a society also, and the socio-economical conditions also. Now, which are the scopes of the fruit production? We have seen the importance and scope of the horticulture in the first semester, but now especially for the fruit crops, let us see which are the importance or the scopes. Because we are having a lot of scope, because need of the increased production to meet dietary requirements as per the capita consumption of the fruits in India is very low. USA 202 kg per capita per year is the consumption. In the Pakistan it is 100 kg, while in India we are having only 10 kg of the fruit consumption per capita per year. So it is very meager figure, we can say, and very less. So we have to increase this figure. And to increase this figure, there is a lot of scope. The low consumption of the fruit is only due to very small fraction of the total cropped area under the fruits. As we have seen, 0.7% of the total cultivable area is under the fruit crop production. So this also a very meager. India needs to step up the production of the fruit till the country becomes self-sufficient and process of the fruit fall to the level at which both rich and poor can afford to buy. So this is our aim, and to reach that aim, we are having a lot of scope to increase the production and productivity as well as area of the fruit crops. The prices of the fruits are so high as to keep fresh fruits out of reach of the large population with more efficient production and marketing. The price could be reduced as to increase consumption of fruits and still providing good profit to the growers. So we have to increase the production of the fruits so that each and every person or the even these poor people can consume it. Increasing the irrigation facilities, most of the commercial fruits requires perennial irrigation. The area receiving the perennial irrigation, which was 6% in 1960 and is reached a level of the 12.5% to 30% today. So it has been increased, and because of the increase in the irrigation facilities, there are a lot of scopes for the horticultural crops. By exploiting all these resources, the maximum area that can be brought under the irrigation would be 25% of the total cropped area. So there are still up to 13% to the 25% we can reach. So lot of scopes are still there. to increase the facility and finally the area and production of the fruit crops. Thus, there is still scope of increasing irrigated area in near future as government is giving priorities to such to work. This would be definitely help to increase the area under the fruit crops. Scope for increasing area under dry land fruits. As it is not entirely true that all the fruits require perennial irrigation, there are many fruits, fruit trees like bear, custard apple, cashew nut, onla, which are hardy in nature and can be grown purely under the rain-fed conditions. In India, 86 million hectare and in Maharashtra, 35 lakh hectare land is available for the development of the sound technology of rain-fed horticulture. There is good scope to put these lands under the dry land fruit crops. This would also be necessary to arrest shrinkage of the land available for cultivation on per capita basis due to the population pressure. So whatever the land we are not using nowadays, we can cover it under the cultivation by using these crops like bear, custard apple and cashew nut and onla, we can plant it. And government of Gujarat also has taken the initiative that which are the barren lands or the uncultivable lands are there. They are having one scheme so that some societies or the huge companies as well as some person also, they can have this land under for the lease for certain years and they can grow the these horticultural crops. So by this we can increase the area and production. And fourth one is increasing urbanization and change in the food habits. Now, as you know, due to this pandemic also, people are consuming lot of fruits and vegetables nowadays. And because of the urbanization also, the consumption or the demand of these fruits and vegetables has been increased. So, change in the food habits and consuming more fruits, a lot of scopes are there. And previously, transport facility was not much more feasible for these fruit crops because fruits are very much highly perishable and having less storage life and need quick disposal or the transportation to reach to the consumer. So previously, facility was lacking or we can say it was faulty, but nowadays, a lot of facilities for the transportation is found here in the country. So, because increased transport facilities, now we can have a lot of scopes for the increase the area of the fruit production and we can have the more prices because of these transportation facilities. And sixth one is increasing the cold storage facilities and pre-cooling centers. Previously government was not having any this type of facilities. But nowadays, government is having an initiative for the farmers as well as the growers, so that they can have their own cold storage facilities and pre-cooling chambers or pre-cooling centers, we can say, so that we can save the post-harvest losses of the fruits. So because of this also, we can have the lot of scope for the fruits. Scope for the agro-based industries, as I told you, this is a horticultural crops and especially fruit crops are the mother of all the industries or lot of industries. So, because of this raw products, whatever are having, we can use it in these different industries and we can also establish the industries like canning and preservation industries because of this horticultural crops, especially for the fruit crops. And development of the new technologies is also there. See, previously there was no much more scope for the horticulture because of this less research was there in horticulture crops, but nowadays we are having a innovative technologies like use of growth regulators, in situ grafting, drip irrigation for water economy, tissue culture, special horticultural practices like ringing, girdling, notching, bahar treatments, high density planting. So because of all these, we can have a lot of scope for the fruit crops. And evolution of the new high yielding varieties and introduction of the new crops. So because in last 2-3 decades this lot of research has been made and development of the high yielding variety of fruits like pomegranate, that is Ganesh, P23, P26, G137, and especially this Bagua variety in pomegranate also is nowadays working in this area. And in mango, Ratna, Amaravati, Mallika, Shindu, and in the grapes, Thompson seedless, Guava, Sardar L49, Cashew nut, Vengula number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 have to bring more area under the fruits. Similarly, introduction of the commercial cultivation of the some new crops like bear, onla, etc. under the commercial cultivation will expand the area. Availability of the loan facilities. As I told you previously, not much more facilities were there, but nowadays each and every nationalized bank having these facilities, and farmers, or you can say growers, can have easily loan for the growing of the new orchard. And government is, as I told, initiative is there. Realizing the need of the area expansion of the fruit crops, the governments have started a very ambitious program of fruit development, under which it gives 100% subsidy to the marginal farmers and farmers from the backward communities, and 70% subsidy for the others on establishment and maintenance of fruits orchards for a period of 3 years. This would increase the area under fruits. It is expected that due to this program, the area under fruit is in Maharashtra by 94 to 95 would increasing in lot of hectares. And Government of India, this State Department of Horticulture, is also giving very attractive subsidies to the farmers nowadays. And scope for the export of the fruits. Market surveys in Europe and other markets have revealed that is a good scope for or the export of the grapes, mango, banana, pomegranate, citrus, bear, cashew nut, and whatnot. So each and every product we are having in this horticulture, especially in fruit crops, they are having a chances for the export in the foreign countries. The availability of these markets would be increased area under the fruits. And finally, availability of the cheap labor is also, we are having this because of the lot of population in the country. Availability of the cheap labor is there. Very high production of the fruit, as we have seen in the previous slides. And suitability of climate for fruits are some of the other factors indicating scope for the fruits. As we have seen in the previous semester, that we are having varied climatic conditions. So one or the another crop can be, horticultural crops can be grown in these climatic conditions. Now, this was for the fruit crops. Now, importance for the plantation crops. The term plantation crop refers to those crops which are cultivated on an extensive scale in a large contiguous area owned and managed by an individual or the company. So, this is plantation crop. The crops including tea, coffee, rubber, cocoa, coconut, areca nut, oil palm, palmyra palm, cashew nut, and cinchona, etc. can be classified or it can be included under the plantation crops. These plantation crops are high value commercial crops of greater economic importance and play a vital role in our Indian economy. The main drawback with this sector of crops in India is that major portion of the area is of small holdings except tea, which hinders the adoption of the intensive cultivation. So because generally we are having this border plantation or a very small holding plantation is there, so we are not having much more nowadays we are not able to adopt the intensive or the higher technologies. But if it will be planted in a systematic manner, then we can use it in intensive manner, in an intensive cultivation. In the case of the coffee, 97.13% of the growers have holdings below 10 hectares. And in rubber, also 82% of the total area is under the small holdings. So because of the small holding, intensive cultivation we are not having, and all the technologies are having limitations to use under this condition. The economic importance of these crops are, we can see, they contribute to the national economy. By the way of the export earning, these crops occupy less than 2% of the total cultivated area. That is 3.82% of the total crop land, but they generate an income of around 16,000 million, or about, we can say, 12.72% of the total export earnings of all the commodities, or we can say up to the 75% of the total earnings from the export of the agricultural produces. So we are having a very small area, but because of the higher prices, it plays a very vital role in the Indian economy. India is the leading country in the total production of the certain plantation crops in the world. For example, our production meets the share of 47% in tea and 66% in each of cashew nut and areca nut. The plantation industry provides direct as well as indirect employment to many millions of the people in the country. For example, this tea industry offers direct employment to the 10 lakhs and indirect employment to the 10 lakhs people, while cashew nut processing factories alone provides employment up to the 3 lakhs people. Besides, 2 lakhs farmers are employed in this cashew nut cultivation. So it is having a lot of economic importance for this landless labor, or sometimes for the laborers. Plantation industries supports many byproduct industries and also many rural industries. For example, coconut husk is used to produce core fiber annually to a tune of 219,600 tons in India. So this is only one example, but all the these plantation crops are having one or the another support to the industries. These crops helps to conserve the soil and ecosystem. Tea planted in hill slopes and cashew nut in the barren and wastelands protects the land from soil erosion during the rainy season or due to the heavy winds. Now these are the area of plantation crops in India. You can go through these figures. So this was all about the importance and scope of the fruit crops as well as for the plantation crops. Thank you.